We feel that we've been backed into a corner and we're sort of, you know, against the ropes, and the only way out is to fight our way out. So my biggest concern with this is that, you know, the members have been obviously reluctant to take industrial action. This is not something that anybody wants to do, but we feel that we have a very small window in which to act. We've wanted to minimize the impact on the public as much as possible, so we've started by not wearing uniform, hoping that, you know, we would be able to progress negotiations. That has been not possible. So this week, unfortunately, we've had to put in the first measure that may affect the public, no, with a non-answering of the telephones and one in the vehicle traffic. We do not want to paralyze things. We want to minimize the impact, keep that on. But unfortunately, we have not been given enough time. And had the acting collector of customs told us about non-rotation in June or July or even May or April, no, we would have had all this time to say, look, we don't think this is a good idea, to negotiate, to dialogue. But unfortunately, having been given this answer in October, that's what we don't have. They haven't given us any time to maybe dialogue or engage.
The public needs to understand that if you apply to the customs department, you apply as a custom officer, taking into consideration that you could be posted in a given section. Back in 2013, we did negotiate with the management at the time a rotation agreement in which we incorporated certain specialized sections into the department with a bespoke agreement. The fact is now that we are in a situation when it's 2016 and we've asked management to incorporate actually this section and another section. The other section, we haven't had any problem from management.
The issue here is the introduction of systemic unfairness in the department. There was systemic unfairness when I first started representing customs in 2012. That was broken through intense industrial action and intense union efforts. And now the situation is that we are regressing into a situation of systemic unfairness again. And as a trade union, we cannot accept it.
As a matter of fact, the Marine section was initiated in 2016. And has had quite a few years to try and fully run the section. So this year we did ask the management to incorporate the Marine section into the rotation agreement, like other sections in the department.
Unite has the negotiating rights for the Marine section. In any issue that impacts the entire department, it is the majority union that holds the negotiating rights. We have 85% of the membership. Any rotation of any section will impact upon every single officer in the department. So we feel that we hold the negotiating rights for the entirety of the rotation agreement. We're not apportioning any blame on Unite at all. This is the employer, because the employer decides who the employer is going to sit with to negotiate.
I am a custom officer myself. Although I'm here in the capacity of the Vice President for the GGCA, but the mood is quite heated.
I'm sure that it's a balancing act. You want the industrial action to have some teeth, but you also risk turning public opinion against the GGCA and customs, which would be counterproductive.
Absolutely, and that is the difficulty with this, you know, and we're not pretending otherwise. This is the situation we find ourselves in, and we're doing our best.